That's okay.
Yeah, am I going to be in the way or?
No, they'll come in front of you. They'll walk in behind you.
They're walking behind me.
Seven, after.
After Silent Night.
I
Good morning. Okay, that's not working.
Good morning. So, all right, what I would ask you to do, I talked to Father this is the first time I'll be in this religious service. So the chorus is going to come up. We stand just like if they were altar servers coming in to for a mass. Father will give you the tell you to be seated either by verbal or he'll just signal with his hands. All right? So, Mr. Shustock, I don't know if they're ready. And they process in, I'll give you the signal to stand.
Thank you.
Brothers and sisters, let's begin in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. The Lord be with you. We gather here to recall the mystery of our redemption. Though sin drew us away from God, He never stopped loving us. The prophets told of the coming of a Messiah who would initiate a reign of justice and peace. This promise was fulfilled in the incarnation of our Lord Jesus Christ. Let us now reflect with joy on His wondrous mystery.
Now the snake was the most cunning of all the wild animals that the Lord God had made. He asked the woman, "Did God really say, 'You shall not eat from any of the trees in the garden?'" The woman answered the snake, "We may eat of the fruit of the trees in the garden. It is only about the fruit of the tree in the middle of the garden that God said, 'You shall not eat it or even touch it, or else you will die.'" But the snake said to the woman, "You certainly will not die. God knows well that when you eat of it, your eyes will be opened, and you will be like gods, who know good and evil." The woman saw that the tree was good for food and pleasing to the eyes, and the tree was desirable for gaining wisdom. So she took some of its fruit and ate it. And she also gave some to her husband, who was with her, and he ate it too. Then the eyes of both of them were opened, and they knew that they were naked. So they sewed fig leaves together and made loincloths for themselves. When they heard the sound of the Lord God walking about in the garden at the breezy time of the day, the man and his wife hid themselves from the Lord God among the trees of the garden. Then Lord God called to the man and asked him, "Where are you?" He answered, "I heard you in the garden, but I was afraid because I was naked, so I hid." Then God asked, "Who told you that you were naked? Have you eaten from the tree of which I have forbidden you to eat?" The man replied, "The woman whom you put me here with, she gave me fruit from the tree, so I ate it." The Lord God then asked the woman, "What is this you have done?" The woman answered, "The snake tricked me, so I ate it." Then the Lord God said to the snake, "Because you have done this, cursed are you among the animals, tame or wild. On your belly you shall crawl, and dust you shall eat all the days of your life. I will put enmity between you and the woman, and between your offspring and hers. They will strike at your head while you strike at their heel."
Thank you.
Lord of mercy, despite our sinfulness, you never stop loving us. Fill our hearts with your mercy, that we may forgive others. Amen.
See, days are coming, Oracle of the Lord, when I raise up a righteous branch for David. As king he shall reign and govern wisely. He shall do what is just and right in the land. In his days Judah shall be saved, Israel shall dwell in security. This is the name to be given to him, the Lord our justice. Therefore the days are coming, Oracle of the Lord, when there shall no longer say, as the Lord lives, who brought the Israelites out of the land of Egypt, but rather, as the Lord lives, who brought the descendants of the house of Israel up from the land of the north, and from all the lands to which I banished them, they shall live again in their own soil.
Promise that your reign would bring the justice that would never end. May we help to bring this justice in our time. Amen.
But a shoot shall sprout from the stump of Jesse, and from his roots a bud shall blossom. The spirit of the Lord shall rest upon him, a spirit of wisdom and of understanding, a spirit of counsel and of strength, a spirit of knowledge and of fear of the Lord. And his delight shall be the fear of the Lord. Not by appearance shall he judge, nor by hearsay shall he decide. But he shall judge the poor with justice, and decide fairly for the lands afflicted. He shall strike the ruthless with the rod of his mouth, and with the breath of his lips he shall slay the wicked. Justice shall be the band around his waist, and faithfulness a belt upon his lips. Then the wolf shall be a guest of the lamb, and the leopard shall lie down with the young goat. The calf and the young lion shall browse together, with a little child to guide them. The cow and the bear shall graze, together their young shall lie down. The lion shall eat hay like the ox. The baby shall play by the viper's den, and the child shall lay his hand on the adder's lair. They shall not harm or destroy on all my holy mountain, for the earth shall be filled with the knowledge of the Lord, as water covers the sea. On that day, the root of Jesse set up as a signal for the peoples. Him the nations will seek out. His dwelling shall be glorious.
Lord, we wait for the day of your peace. May we help to bring this peace in our families, our communities, and our entire world. Amen.
The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Upon those who lived in a land of gloom, a light has shone. You have brought them abundant joy and great rejoicing. They rejoice before you as people rejoice at harvest, as they exult when dividing the spoils. For the yoke that has burdened them, the pull on their shoulder, the rod of their taskmaster, you have smashed, as on the day of the Midian. For every boot that tramped in battle, every cloak rolled in blood, will be burned as fuel for fire. For a child is born to us, a son is given to us. Upon his shoulder, dominion rests. They name him Wonder Counselor, God Hero, Father Forever, Prince of Peace. His dominion is vast and forever peaceful. Upon David's throne and over his kingdom, which he confirms and sustains by judgment and justice, both now and forever. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this.
And he will rule over the house of Jacob forever. word. Then the angel departed from her.
Thank you.
Lord, you asked Joseph and Mary to trust in you. May we come to share in their trust and always rely on you. Amen.
In those days, a decree went out from Caesar Augustus that the whole world should be enrolled. This was the first enrollment when Quirinius was governor of Syria. So all went to be enrolled, each to his own town. And Joseph, too, went up from Galilee, from the town of Nazareth to Judea, to the city of David that is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and family of David, to be enrolled with Mary, his betrothed, who was with child. While they were there, the time came for her to have her child, and she gave birth to her firstborn son. She wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. Now there were shepherds in that region, living in the fields and keeping a night watch over their flock. The angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were struck with great fear. The angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for behold, I proclaim to you good news of great joy that will be for all the people. For today in the city of David, a Savior has been born for you, who is Messiah and Lord. And this will be a sign for you. You will find an infant wrapped in swaddling clothes and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was a multitude of the heavenly host with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to those on whom his favor rests." When the angels went away from them to heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go then to Bethlehem to see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us." So they went in haste and found Mary and Joseph and the infant lying in the manger. When they saw this, they made known the message that had been told them about this child. All who heard it were amazed by what had been told them by the shepherds. Lord, you came to us in humility and vulnerability. May we always show loving care to those around us, especially to those most in need. Amen. When Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea in the days of King Herod, behold, Magi from the east arrived in Jerusalem, saying, "Where is the newborn King of the Jews? We saw his star at its rising and have come to do him homage." When King Herod heard this, he was greatly troubled, and all Jerusalem with him.
Assembling all the chief priests and the scribes of the people, he inquired of them where the Messiah was to be born. They said to him, "In Bethlehem of Judea, for thus it has been written through the prophet, 'And you, Bethlehem, land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah, since from you shall come a ruler who is to shepherd my people Israel.' Then Herod called the Magi secretly and ascertained them from the time of the star's appearance. He sent them to Bethlehem and said, 'Go and search diligently for the child. When you have found him, bring me word that I too may go and do him homage.' After their audience with the king, they set out. And behold, the star that they had seen at its rising preceded them, until it came and stopped over the place where the child was. They were overjoyed at seeing the star, and on entering the house, they saw the child with Mary, his mother. They prostrated themselves and did him homage. Then they opened their treasures and offered him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And having been warned in a dream not to return to Herod, they departed for their country by another way."
Thank you.
Lord, you are the giver of all good gifts. May we always remember to share our gifts with others for the glory of your name. Amen.
In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things came to be through him, and without him nothing came to be. What came to be through him was life, and this life was the light of the human race. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it. A man named John was sent from God. He came for testimony, to testify to the light, so that all might be, that all might believe through him. He was not the light, but came to testify to the light. The true light, which enlightens everyone, was coming into the world. He was in the world, and the Lord came to be through him, but the world did not know him. But to those who did accept him, he gave power to become children of God, to those who believe in his name, who were born not by natural generation, nor by human choice, nor by man's decision, but of God. And the Word became flesh and made his dwelling among us. And we saw his glory, the glory as of the Father's only Son, full of grace and truth.
Thank you.
God of power and might, you are beyond all time and space. May we never fail to recognize your majesty and give praise to you in all we do. Amen.
The 11 disciples went to Galilee, to the mountain to which Jesus had ordered them. When they saw him, they worshiped, but they doubted. Then Jesus approached, and he said to them, "All power in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Go, therefore, make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, teaching them to observe all that I have commanded you. And behold, I am with you always until the end of the age."
Lord, you call us to be your witnesses to the ends of the earth. Fill our words with power, that we may proclaim your good news and draw all people to you. Amen. Before the final blessing, I just want to thank everyone who helped make this Lessons in Carol such a beautiful event, with special thanks to Mr. John Shustock and all the musicians who generously used their talents today for the glory of God. Thank you. And if I can ask everyone to please stand. The Lord be with you. And may Almighty God bless all of you gathered here in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Go in peace. Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
Okay, before we leave, folks, I want to thank the choir. Let's give them a round of applause. All the choruses did a great job. And also in the background, I think you had some band member, the brass. They were in the background. You probably couldn't see them. Thank them. Mr. Schusdock, Mr. Ranzinger, and Dr. Stedmeyer was the accompanist here, so thank you. All right. They're going to perform tonight also, so if you want to come back tonight, 7 o'clock, is that what time? All right, if you want to see them again. All right, you're going to E period, so you've got like 10 minutes to get there, so if you would dismiss. You've done a great job. Thank you, audience. You've done a great job. Thank you. Y'all did.